Good morning, students. Myself, Meenal Sakpar. Today, we are going to start part 2 of lesson number 2, The Living World. The topic for today is responsiveness to stimuli, reproduction, a definite lifespan, cellular structure, useful and harmful living things. Responsiveness to stimuli. We define it as the ability to respond to a stimulus is called responsiveness to stimuli. I have given two examples over here. The first example is of mimosa plant. When you touch the leaves of the mimosa plant, it automatically closes. That means it is responding to the activity when you touch the leaves. The second example, a person is trying to touch the hot object, and as he touches the hot object, he is responding. So, all living things respond to the activity that occurs in the near surroundings. This is called stimulus. In the first example, when a person touches the hot object, he leaves the object as it is hot. That means he is responding to the activity. The second example shows us that the person is running away as he sees the bear. That means he is responding to the activity. Next characteristics is reproduction. The process by which a living thing generates a new living thing like itself is called reproduction. Different organisms have different ways of reproduction. Reproduction is also known as procreation. Some animals give birth to their young ones. For example, a mother gives birth to a child, a cow gives birth to a calf, a dog gives birth to a puppy, and a cat gives birth to a kitten. Some lay eggs from which young ones hatch out. Plants reproduce through seeds, parts of stem, and leaves. Next characteristics, a definite life span. Every living thing has a definite life span. Life comes to an end with death, when organs become weak. That means every human being, every living thing has a certain duration of life. After that, it comes to an end when organs become weak. Every plants and animals have different lifespan. I have given you many examples of plants and animals. Some animals, plants, lives for many years, and some lives for some weeks or months. You can see this in the pictures given below. The next characteristics is cellular structure. Living things are made up of small units called as cells. Cells are the building blocks of living things. All action and processes of living things are dependent on cells. Cells are divided into two parts: unicellular organisms and multicellular organisms. Uni means one. Cellular means cell. The living thing which are made up of single cell, they are called unicellular organism. Multicellular organism, the living things which are made up of many cells, they are called multicellular organism. Then we have useful living things and harmful living things. Living things, some are useful and some are harmful. Plants. Some plants are used for medicinal purposes. For example, vasaka, that is adusa, asparagus, that is shatavari, and many more. Some plants are used as food, that is potato, okra, that is bhindi, Fenugreek, we called it as methi, apple, and many other fruits and vegetables are used as food. Some useful animals. Animals are used as pets like dog, cats. Some are used for transport, camel, horse, and many more. And some are used as food, that is fish, sheep, goat, etc. There are some harmful living things also. Plants. Plants which pollute the water are the uncontrolled growth of algae. Plants which cause itching is called colocasia leaves. Plants which are poisonous is datura. It is very poisonous for living things. Harmful animals which spread diseases like mosquitoes and flies. Some causes skin diseases, live and ticks. Some destroys food, that is cockroach, mice, rat, and many more. And some animals can even cause death, like snakes and scorpions. There are many other useful and harmful living things. Thank you.